been, the Cheltenham Festivals have grown and grown over the years and is well known both domestically and internationally. What are some of the keys to your success?
I think there's probably many elements why the festivals have grown so much in the last kind of 5-10 years particularly. I think for us, we're quite unique as an organisation because we have both arts and science within our festival portfolio. We're also in the middle of a beautiful Regency town, so the festivals, the fact that they're in parks, they're a bit of a hybrid between kind of greenfield festivals and venue-based festivals, so you get the best of both worlds in that sense. And the main thing for us is that we try and put on a lot of unique things. So a lot of our content we try and produce is things you won't see anywhere else and you can only see here in Cheltenham. We also, I think for the size of the town, we bring a lot in terms of kind of international quality performance.
And what are the highlights of the festivals this year?
The highlight for jazz will be Kamasi Washington, the big US player, a great saxophone player who's really kind of bringing a new audience to jazz. We have our science festival, which starts in Imperial Gardens in June. And one of the big attractions we're launching for this year is our Cyber Zone. So that's a whole area where you can come in and find out the latest kind of companies and technologies and where the kind of the cyber is the future of the, particularly the region, but also internationally as well. And then the music festival, which is in July, we have probably the world's best violinist in Maxim Vengerov. So he'll be joining us for a performance at the Town Hall in July. And our literature festival, although in October, we're already out there with big names which you'll be coming and announce soon.
And the festivals attracts large crowds and you get great talent here. But what is less well known is you're a charity. Can you tell us about that and what you do in the community?
A lot of people actually don't know we're a charity. So we're a not-for-profit charity. We have been since 1945 when we started out. We actually work with over 25,000 school children, over 250 schools over the year, and in many ways. So we try and make sure we get as many kind of pupils and students here and community groups to the festivals themselves. We also go out into those communities and to those schools. And for us, it's not just about kind of a tokenism in the sense of, you know, you do one thing and then they never hear from us again. We try and work with different schools or communities over a 3 or 5 year period to make sure that we really embed our philosophies with them. And actually for us, it's trying to make the most of getting the big talent, if you like, the big names, to make sure that they're kind of involved in our community and education program too.
And how can the business community engage with the festivals?
There's so many ways we like to engage with businesses. I think first and foremost, we hope that they're proud of the festivals and that they're keen to talk about us to anybody that they come across in terms of their customers or their businesses. That's our starting point. We just want people to spread the word, you know, what we do for the town and the fact that we're a charity as well. There are lots of more formal ways of getting involved. We have something called a champion scheme, which is really if people want to kind of note us as part of their kind of CSR and supporting the charity, that they recognise that what we bring to the town from an economic point, as well as more obvious kind of, you know, sponsorship opportunities. But also we work with a lot of businesses as venues. We have something called Around Town that we work on with Cheltenham Bid here. And that's all about making sure that we immerse ourselves back into the fabric of the town. And we do have the villages of the parks and the tents, but we also want to use some of the great buildings and venues and bars and restaurants.
And what are your plans for the festivals in the coming years?
I think one of our main plans for the festivals is to continue to increase our amount of unique content. So those things you simply won't see anywhere else rather than here. We're also looking to double our free events around across the festivals, and that's something we're taking very seriously as we kind of plan to the next 3 to 5 years. But continue to deliver the best talent that we can to Cheltenham, continue to deliver unique things, increase our education and community work, and absolutely always have that at the heart of what we do.